No. No, no, wait, I'm not...
It took courage. It took courage to climb into that machine every night, not knowing if I'd be the man in the box. Or in the prestige. Do you want to see what it cost me?
Hey guys, this is just going to be a quick thought experiment. I'm going to delve a little further into the assumptions and the evidence for my views on functionalism a little bit later. I thought I'd break it up a little bit and just ask a few questions, perhaps get a few responses. Now this thought experiment will be very, very familiar to some of you who have already gotten to grips with the subject, and you may have already considered the answers. However, I really want people to perhaps think about the actual implications of the assumptions that they may have about the subject. This very thought experiment sort of, I guess it stems from the early work of Hobbes, and it's so much in our culture now, but mainly I'm going to be talking about the work of Parfit's teleportation. So the experiment goes something like this. There's a really nice planet orbiting Alpha Centauri. It's one of the best holidays that you'll ever go on. Not only that, when we get the technology to teleport ourselves there, let's say it's 20 years in the future, and if things are going the way that they are, then Earth might not be the best place to live. So we have this ability to teleport ourselves there, and we've also mastered the art of quantum tunneling to such a large extent that we can step through this teleporter, which will model all the atoms and the subatomic particles that constitute your body, and it reconstructs them on this new planet orbiting Alpha Centauri, which is a utopia compared to here. And so you step through the teleporter and you arrive, or at least a copy of you arrives on this new planet. Now the old copy, it has to be killed. There are certain ethical guidelines in place that say there can't be two of you, just in case you get up to any mischief, even though you're miles apart, let's just say. So you get copied and then you die. That's the end of this particular instance of you. However, the other copy is allowed to continue. Now, the technology is fully tested and everything, that's a given. People have written postcards back from there somehow through other methods of quantum communication, and it's a really nice place. So I really want to gather people's responses and the reasons for those responses. I'm going to ask a question that really divides into two questions, I suppose. Would you step through the teleporter? This question, I think, divides into two, because there might be some cognitive dissonance. I know I certainly might have some cognitive dissonance. Would you step through the teleporter on an intellectual level? That is, do you think it matters? So what this question is about, the first one, is the very continuity of ourselves important, or is it merely the actual atoms that constitute our body and things like that? Is there anything missing? Again, I've demonstrated, well, at least I've argued before, that a functionally identical copy will behave in exactly the same way and things like that. So this copy, at least it's going to think that it's you, have all your memories, your dispositions, your experiences from the past, but it won't be made of the same matter that you are now. So that leads to another question. would you actually do it? It's all well and good saying that, yes, it doesn't matter if I step through the teleporter, but would you actually do it? I myself might have some qualms with this, but I'm just going to keep this short, so that's my question. Would you step through the teleporter on an intellectual level? And then, practically, would you actually step through the teleporter? More on consciousness later. Hope to hear back from some of you. Peace.